And John's teammate, Greg Davis. Since taking up acting, Greg has put his day job as a teacher behind him and shown off the incredibly diverse range of characters he can play. Whether it's head of sixth form in The Inbetweeners or a member of the drama faculty in Man Down, he can do it all. Greg, do you think you'd be better at the numbers or the letters?
I think I'd be absolutely awful at all of it.
You used to be a teacher.
Yeah, I know, but I taught drama. Come on. The times I wrote a word on a whiteboard and one of the kids went, "That's not how you spell that." And I went, "Very well done." Spotted it. Nice. Oh, I'll be absolutely rubbish at this game.
Do you think John will make a good teammate?
Yes, I do.
Thanks, mate.
No worries, mate.
What? Why?
I like a little small guy. I like people that I could sort of just hold, like, oh, that's it.
But you're not that much bigger than John, are you?
What? Are you all right, Jimmy? Of course I am. I can carry John out of this room like a rolled-up carpet.
The best way to spot it is John's on a chair and Greg's sitting on the floor.
Greg, what's your eight?
It's pronounced Illuim said.
Illuim said.
Yeah. I-L-O-U-M-S-E-D.
What is it, well?
I'm not sure exactly what it is. It's something to do with sewing in Europe.
Susie?
Yeah, it's a highly decorated bobbin used exclusively.
It's not.
All right. I knew I was going to be bad at this show, so I talked to Susie before.
Did you get anything?
Yeah, I got Miles 5 letters.
Is that just because he sat there?
OK, now, before we get on with the game, last time you were on the show, Greg, you did an incredible impersonation of Chris Eubank.
Correct.
what? No.
Yeah, and I've had lots of people come up to me in the street and say that they thought Sean was extremely harsh on my impression and that it is indeed the greatest Chris Eubank impression of all time.
I've got some famous sort of speeches for you. Could you give us a little bit more of the Chris Eubanks? Because it's pretty extraordinary.
Are you joking? I was born to do it.
OK, Holly, could you pass those over to... It's an incredible voice.
OK.
We shall fight them on the beach. We shall fight them on the beach, yes. We shall fight them on the landing ground. We shall never surrender.
It's good, but I feel there's more.
Now is the winter of our discontent. Made glorious summer by this son of York.
Why are you making me do this again?
I really like it. It does sound brilliant, but you're not the only person that does a brilliant Chris Eubank. I've got someone here who does the voice, I mean, pretty bloody well. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Chris Eubank.
Oh, fuck off.
Cool. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
It is indeed the greatest form of theatre.
I'm so frightened. I'm so, so frightened.
Chris, what do you think of the impression?
It's wonderful. The fact that he cannot hold a straight face, it means it's fantastic. It works.
It is. I bet if we covered Sean's eyes and Chris and I both...
I have something for you. So this is the challenge. I have a tongue twister for you, gentlemen. You could pass that down. That's a tongue twister for both Chris Eubanks. And Sean is going to cover his eyes and try and establish which one is reading.
OK. First, he killed the Misha Mokwa, greatest bear of all the mountains.
From the skin?
It's OK, so the other guy has a go.
From the skin? He might metal.
Made them with the fur side inside. Made them with the skin side outside.
To get the warm side inside, he put the inside side outside. Why?
He put the skin side outside.
Why?
He turned them inside out.
Outside.
Who was that?
Who was that?
Yeah.
That was Chris. And then Greg, sort of, every now and again.
And
who else?
Vic.
Maybe you're not quite as good at guessing who Chris Eubank is as you think you are.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Eubank, everyone.
Incidentally, can I just say to all the people involved in the production, you pricks. I shat myself.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Chris Eubank.
Oh, fuck off.